But first, can robotics and artificial intelligence help improve that rush hour commute you're facing? Experts at Carnegie Mellon University think they can by monitoring traffic flow in real time. Jeffrey Brown has the story from Pittsburgh, part of our weekly series on the leading edge of science and technology.
You know the frustration. You're late for work or to pick up your child. You're driving through city streets, and every block or two, it seems, there's another red light.
It's a problem that plagues commuters across the country. In fact, according to a Texas A&M study, the average commuter in the U.S. spends upwards of 42 hours a year at a complete standstill, stuck in traffic.
Heavy congestion still from Neville Island towards Crafton. It opens up for you at the Parkway.
8 years ago, traffic problems in Pittsburgh got the attention of a local philanthropist who gave seed money to Carnegie Mellon University. The idea, to have its robotics experts use artificial intelligence to create a smarter transportation grid that will eventually remake the commute for drivers, cyclists, and bus riders. Almost half of all Pittsburgh commuters drive alone in their cars, so the first priority was road congestion. Courtney Ehrlichman helps run the program called Traffic 21.
The problem in Pittsburgh is like the problems around the country is that we have this existing infrastructure that was designed many, many years ago, and you really can't expand it. You really have to optimize the system. Mm-hmm. And so we have an opportunity here using these technologies to make our system more efficient and to optimize it rather than trying to figure out how to build more.
We're going with the flow right now, so we're getting the greens.
Professor Steve Smith thinks he's discovered a key to optimizing traffic flow. He's created software that's currently deployed at 100 intersections in a pilot area of East Pittsburgh.
Conventional signal systems are pre-programmed, so it's really designed for average traffic flows as opposed to actual traffic flows.
So then the trick is to make it as real time.
Right, and you know, we're watching the real traffic. Yeah.
Smith's technology uses existing cameras and radar to track how many cars are approaching. Then an algorithm determines how to efficiently move the cars through. That program controls the lights and also sends information to neighboring intersections.
Essentially, we're trying to build a signal timing plan that moves all the vehicles from these four different views through the intersection.
Without a lot of waiting time.
Yeah, but it also then communicates to its downstream neighbors what traffic it expects to be sending their way.
Yeah.
So now downstream neighbor, let's say it's this guy, which is a downstream neighbor, is building its own local plan, but now in addition...
It knows what's coming.
Now in addition to what it sees in front of it, it has an idea of what's coming down the pike behind what it can see.
All right, so here's one of your boxes.
Yeah.
The traffic plans are recalculated every few seconds using a small computer installed at each intersection. Smith says the program has made a noticeable difference.
We pretty consistently get, on average through the day, 25% reduction in travel times. Not so much because vehicles are moving faster, but they're stopping 30% fewer times.
They're just continuing to move.
And when they do stop, they're only idling for like 40% less.
This summer, the Pittsburgh Traffic Control Plan won an International Innovation Award. And even better for the city, the U.S. Department of Transportation has announced it's giving $11 million to expand the program to many more intersections.
Traffic is probably the number one issue that we get complaints about.
And that's because, I mean, that's life.
Alex Pejukanix, who works in the mayor's office, says it may be impossible to make everyone happy, but city officials have been pleased with the program so far.
For us, it's really important, and we are seeing improvements in those corridors, and we'd like to find ways to expand the use of technology to solve more city issues.
In fact, Steve Smith and his team are now working on plans to use smartphones so that cyclists and pedestrians can digitally talk to the intersections to help their commutes, too.
Another problem for drivers and the city, potholes and decaying streets. And there's a project underway here to deal with that as well.
Pittsburgh has more than 800 miles of roads and, like most cities, a limited budget to maintain them. Professor Christoph Mertz has devised software that could help the city better determine where to send repair crews.
So the idea is pretty simple, right?
Use the
camera that we all carry around.
Right. I mean, it's just a smartphone.
The phone, which can be mounted on the windshield of any vehicle, records video of the road. Then comes the technological wizardry. Merge develops software that quickly analyzes the footage and is capable of distinguishing between small cracks bigger problems.
So the machine has to think, what is that?
With artificial intelligence, it's like a big word. And in the past, people thought that when a machine can play chess, then it's intelligent. And it plays chess, but that's all it can do, right? It does, that program does not help us fix the roads. And so our program will recognize roads.
Can't play chess.
But can't play chess.
The program also provides simple-to-use color-coded mapping.
So if I'm a city civil engineer or city manager, how do I use this?
You could say, okay, here's the red, so I'm going to do all the red stuff. Okay, but this is the main road. Even if it's just yellow, I need to fix that because there's much more traffic and it's more important.
Merckx and Carnegie Mellon have just launched a private spin-off company called Robotics to sell the technology to local governments. The nearby town of North Huntingdon was first to sign on. One idea is to mount cameras on garbage trucks, which travel every city street once a week.
The idea is here, if it's so inexpensive, you can do it all the time. And so you can address the problems right away.
Maybe before it's a big pothole.
It's a big pothole. So it's like for $1 spent in preventive maintenance, you save $10 in reconstructive maintenance. So it's a huge savings.
Although Pittsburgh was involved in a pilot program using this technology, it hasn't yet signed on to a long-term contract. Alex Pejukanix explains.
Technology is moving very quickly. There's a risk to making a large investment without necessarily knowing what direction the technology is moving. So for us, it's making sure that we're fast and nimble enough to make decisions as the technology evolves.
You mean the technology might be changing so quickly that you're on the wrong technology?
That you could very easily be obsolete after just a few months of having the technology out there. We want to be leading edge, not bleeding edge.
The hope is the new technology will also address public transportation, moving buses along as quickly as possible and giving them priority at crowded intersections. That could lure more commuters out of their cars, further reducing congestion. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Jeffrey Brown in Pittsburgh.